Yo, this is Secret Agent 23 Skidoo. Your library card is your passport to the whole world. So go take a trip at your local library. Peace.
That's one of our friends' contributions. What we do is we help support the programs in the library or whatever else they need. We've helped towards the summer reading program because you know libraries haven't cut, so we help that. So we're looking for people who will generously become a friend. We're also looking for people who would like to volunteer their services to the friend, come up with ideas, programs, or anything else that you can think of that would you would be interested in, you think people would like to come to, or if you have something that you would like yourself to, if you have a specialty that you would like to present to the people. We've had people come in and do watercolors, and we've had an architect come in and talk, and there were other things. So if you have, oh, we also had Tai Chi. We didn't do too well on that. Early in the morning, but it was fun. So I'm, you know, welcome to you. Swadish will talk. We don't do the summer program. We just help it, but we do other things for the library. So that's why you had to be at the book sale. And so, if anybody's interested in joining the Friends or making a donation, Alice has slips for you, and we really hope that you come and join us and have a good time tonight. Okay, and if you didn't get a coupon, we have a lovely CD that is being raffled off for free. Okay, is that it? Can
thank
I do that?
Thank you.
One more thing. The raffle at the end of the program, we will be putting the raffle on the basket. So if anybody wants to make a purchase before the evening is over, feel free to. No, this is something else. That one costs you money. This one is free.
You got those.
Hello.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
On behalf of the Tuckahoe Public Library, myself, along with Charlotte Stubble. Charlotte is not here yet. She's in the city, so hopefully she will be back in a few minutes. I'd like to welcome all of you to the opening night of our 10th annual summer reading game, themed Novel Destination. When Charlotte and I came up with this idea 10 years ago, in the hopes of encouraging our patrons to read more and read more variety of books, we never imagined how amazing the participation would be. Last year, we had 150 people join our team and read over 600 books, all within 10 weeks. Thank you to all of you for your participation, support, and enthusiasm. You helped to make this a highlight of our year. There are lots of people that work behind the scenes to make this all happen. First, I would like to thank the Friends of the Library for their generous donation that helps make evening like this possible. I would also like to thank our director, Debbie Capola. She's also not here, she had to go to the meeting. And other members of our staff, Alan Tenenbaum, Christina Wrenkley, Lisa Ragano, Valerie Murray, Debbie Esponi, Stephanie Capula, Margaret Wiggleman, Christina Davis, Jackie Castro, Diana Ahms, Brian Hackett, Nola Metzler, and Nancy Sisto. Tonight we have a special guest and our local community member, Mr. Glen Roethel, with us. He's a national recording artist who will help us kick off our reading game with a few songs, some familiar and some of his own. We hope you enjoy the performance and leave tonight with your bags filled with great books to help kick off the summer and make this year event more successful. It's my pleasure to present Glen Roethel.
Some little journeys now. Sometimes it'll take you far, sometimes it'll take you near. But at any point in the musical game, if you recognize a place or a novel destination, feel free to shout it out. That one would be, of course, Hawaii.
In my mind, I'm gone to
Can't you see the sunshine? Gold stars!
Can't you just feel the moonshine? Ain't it just like a rain? Hit me from behind. Yes, I'm going to Caroline. Carrying cheese, a silver sun. Best walk away and watch it shine. Watch her watch the morning come. Silver tear appearing, now I'm crying. Ain't I? I'm gonna Caroline in my mind. There ain't no doubt in no one's mind. Love's the finest thing around. Whisper something soft and kind. Hey, baby, the sky's on fire, I'm dying. I'm gone, Caroline, I'm in my mind.
Sing along if you know the words.
In my mind, I'm gone to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine?
Can't you just feel?
Can't you just feel the moonshine? And ain't it just like a friend of mine? Hit me from. Yes, I'm going to Caroline. Dark inside and late last night, I think I might have heard the highway call. Geese in flight, the dogs that bite. The signs in my Creole say I'm going, going, I'm going to Caroline. The holy host of others gathered around. Still I'm on the dark side of the moon. And it seems like it goes on like this forever. You must forgive me if I'm up and gone to Carolina.
Can't you just feel
the moonshine? Ain't it just like a friend of mine? To hit me from behind. Yes, I'm going to Caroline. Thank you very much. Can everybody hear me okay in the back? All right. I'm trying to not shout as loudly as possible. All right. This song has a couple of surprise curveballs in it, so don't think you've finished your task when you name one location, because we're going on a little trip within the song. And that's one of the things I just love about a good book. You're reading the book, you're absorbed in the book, and you're lost in the book. And it takes you to places you really feel like you've traveled. You know, I get that feeling, I'm sure all of you probably love to read if you're here today for novels. So, the funnest part is trying to come back from the book. Like, oh yeah, I'm in my den. there's not a pyramid over there in the corner. You know. And if you need to get up for any reason at all in the middle of a song, it's okay, I won't be upset. But if I do walk up to you, I mean, and sing to you while you're sitting, of course. Don't be upset about that either. This is one of my songs, it's called Something Good. Caroline, sunrise, when the dew is dripping down my window. Old blue heron poking round the mud. clouds move slow and steady, covered crystals getting more merry for a big display wetting down in the forest. I can recall the last rainfall, and I sure it was the start of something good.
Where were we just now? Somewhere in the Carolinas, right? Now we're gonna go to my birthplace.
It was warm in San Diego, where the snowbirds often play. Oh, it had been a long, long time since I'd been. We arrived in late October, under smoke and ash cloud cover, the mercy of Santa Ana winds. We sought shelter near the harbor, then drove fast to Santa Barbara. I could still hear the Beach Boys and America sing songs about Loy, and the desert's blue. Right now, a venture high, smoke is looking, paradise is crying like tears of ash. We've got cactus blossoms in sunlight on Ventura, they're still clearing out the mudslides from the rains. They washed out all the orchards, homes and highways on the hillsides. We all count mixed blessings just the same. I can recall last rainfall, and I sure it was the start of something good. It was the start of something good. It was the start of something good. It was the start of something good.
Let's come back. Now there are two titles to the song.
Yeah.
First title is
Feeling Groovy.
Aha.
Hello. It's the ice cream fridge, so Manhattan.
We're going to Manhattan, and the second title, the 59th Street Bridge Song. Well, who knows what they're calling it now? What is it called today? I don't even know.
Ed Koch Bridge.
Okay. Gee, that just rolls off the tongue like that.
Ed Koch Bridge now. Slow down. Move too fast. Got to make the moment last just. Kicking down the cobblestones, looking for fun.
Feeling groovy.
Uh-huh. I always wanted to do that. Uh-huh. Hello.
Hello, lamppost. What you knowing? I've come to watch your flowers growing. Ain't you got no rhyme for me?
No deeds to do. promises to keep.
I'm dappled in gauzy rainbows.
Read a book.
Let the morning time drop all her petals on me. Life, I love you, all is groovy. I don't like that name, Edgar's Bridge, but hey, it's all right. We need to honor people every now and then. Day-to-day scene, I'll be under the impression I'm somewhere in between. If only two, just me and you, the two things we got to do, the places we got to be. We'll sit beneath the mango tree.
Mango tree?
Mango tree.
Well, it sounds like really Glen really wants to get himself back to Hawaii.
Look at them stars and we're together. Yes, it's always better.
Part.
I often do, yes, lots of fun. I believe in memories, they look so, so pretty when I sleep, hey now, and when I wake up, you look so good, sleeping next to me, but there is not enough time, and there is no song I can sing. There is no combination of words I could say, but I would still tell you one thing, we're better together.
Great time to play another one of my songs. What do you say? Who wants to hear another Glen Roethel song? This one. Well, I don't know, you might read an adventure book.
Sounds good.
Or anything about hiking or kayaking or mountain tops? Well, you may not like to hike yourself, but you might like to read about it. So this is a little song I wrote for my sweetheart who's in the audience. I can tell you who she is. It's called You. Thank you.
drops of rain suspended in air, broken shards of sunlight everywhere. Oh, oh, oh. And there's you. There's you. There's you.
Take a journey, you gotta write a song about that.
Just a song before I go, to whom it may concern. Traveling twice the speed of sound, it's easy to get burned. When the shows were over, we had to get back home. When she helps me with my suitcase, she stands before my eyes, driving me to the airport and to the friendly skies. Go with security, I have for so long. She finds traveling twice the speed of sound. it's easy to get.
I guess you're getting on a plane, you're going someplace. Maybe going to the desert?
On the first part of the journey, I was looking at all the life. There was plants and birds and rocks and things. There was sand and hills and rains. The first thing I met was a fly with a buzz and the sky.
Stuff. Oh, Puff, the magic dragon, lean by
khaki cap to look at, perched on Puff's gigantic tail. Gold kings and princes would bow when they came. Pirate ships would lower their flag, black Puff roared out his name. Oh, Puff, the magic dragon, lived by the sea. In a land called Honolulu, Puff the magic dragon lived by the sea, and frightened in the autumn mist. In a land called Honolulu, a dragon lives forever, but not so little boys. Painted wings and giant rings make way for the toys. One great night it happened, Jackie Pig came no more. Puff that mighty dragon, he ceased his fearless roar. His head was bent in sorrow, green scales fell like rain. Puff no longer went to play along Cherry Lane. Without his lifelong friend, Puff could not be brave. So Puff that mighty dragon sadly slipped into his cave. Oh, Puff the magic dragon lived by the sea, and frolicked in the autumn mist in a land called Honolulu.
It's a real place.
Puff the magic dragon lived by the sea.
Now there's some songs that I don't often play, so I've got my little cheat sheets. A couple of them are in other languages, or sort of. Maybe it's English, but it's from other parts of the world.
All my bags are packed, ready to go. Standing here outside your door, I hate to wake you up to say goodbye. But the dawn is breaking, it's early morning. Taxi's wing is blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome I could cry. So kiss me and smile on me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you never let me go. Every song I sing for you. When I come back, you wear my wedding ring. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you wait for me. Hold me like you never. I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know. more times, let me kiss you. Then close your eyes and I'll be on my way. Your dream about the days to come, when I won't have to feel alone. About the times when I won't have to say, kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you weep for me. Hold me like you never let me go. 'Cause I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Leaving on a jet plane.
go on a train anyway. Does anybody know if there are trains in Hawaii? Thing I was curious about. Totally irrelevant.
Bye.
spark my memories. Oh, some happy, some sad. I think of childhood friends and the dreams we had. We lived happily forever, so the story goes. But somehow we missed out on the pot of gold, but we'll try best that we can to carry on, to carry on.
They make, except for a really tiny one that I think is sort of a novelty instrument. It's really crazy small. But it's the soprano. And they make slightly larger ones, and then slightly, and then they have some with more strings than this. And I chose this one because of the fun factor. You know, I picked it up, I looked at it, and I smiled, and I knew that was it. So, yeah, and it happened to you too, right? You said, like, oh, look, he put his guitar in the dryer too long. Spend a lot of time talking about that moment. All right. So my first CD, my first record that I made, way back in 1995. It's a very very loud song. It's kind of fun and meditative at the same time. It's gonna take us a little bit farther east. I don't mean Riverhead. I mean Montauk.
Namaste, namaste. Namaste, namaste. Am I into? When will I disappear? Will my empty thoughts and mind be free at last from fear? I am shaped without form. I am a song the heart sings. Boundless joy and love am I strive to be all of these things. Namaste. Shanti, shanti, asana. May we live in peace. And may the spirit in me greet your spirit. When my selflessness removes the confusion and opens both my sightless eyes, then I will see the illusion. I am shaped without form. Namaste. I am a song the heart sings. Boundless joy and love am I. Shanti, Shanti Asana. May we live in peace. May the spirit in me greet your spirit. May the spirit in me greet your spirit.
Does everyone know that word, namaste? It's a very, very beautiful Sanskrit word from India that is often a greeting, which one of the many definitions might be.
Swadish is looking at me like, oh yeah, what's it gonna be?
So one definition is, may the spirit in me greet the spirit in you, or may what is sacred in me greet what is sacred in you. It's about how we're all connected and we're all sacred. It's a beautiful greeting. It reminds me of a little story. I was in Beijing. Now, back in 1988, it was back before it became this massive metropolis that it is today. And I visited the Forbidden City in
blank.
I visited the Forbidden City, right in the heart of Beijing. And what an exciting place to visit, with the massive walls, and you go through the big gate, and you go across the great courtyard, and there's a big, gigantic, beautiful building, ancient architecture. With terracotta roof, the tiles and all, and these beautiful curves and the sculptures. You go up the big steps and you go through and you go down the big steps and then you go across another big courtyard and you do this about 7 times. You go straight back, it's this huge. I don't know what was on the left and right, I was too busy going straight down the middle. I went about halfway through. And at that point, I was pretty accustomed to spend some time around, you know, China, which is, you know, still communist China, which is still there, actually. And I was kind of used to getting stared at a lot, because I had the blondish hair and the blue eyes, and I'm really tall, and they had made me keenly aware of the fact that I have a large nose, which is, you don't see a lot of that in China, you know? So I was used to being stared at, and I mean stared at. I would turn around and someone would be this close, and normally if you turn around like an elevator and somebody's standing right there and they happen to make eye contact, you know? No, this way you turn and they stare right at you because they're looking at the blue eyes. What are those? Yeah, you see those? So I've gotten used to it. So now I'm about halfway through the Forbidden City. And it's hot as anything that day. I sit down on the steps, taking a little break. I turn to my bed, and there's a young mother with her little tiny girl with her. And they're sitting right next to me. The little girl's right next to me or something. Oh, good. This is my opportunity to practice my Chinese that I've studied. I learned how to say hello. So I turned to her and I said, how am I? She looks at me and she says, hello. True story.
Now that I've lost everything to you, you say you want to start something new, and it's breaking my heart to you. Baby, I'm leaving, but if you want to leave, take good care. Hope you find a lot of nice friends out there, then a lot of nice things turn bad. It's a wild world.
overtime.
I think everybody's having so much fun.
Are you having a good time? Yeah. All right. Gee, there's so many other songs I wanted to play for you, but I'll tell you what, I think that there's a raffle.
There's always a raffle.
You're not going to win my uke, I'm telling you that right now.
Can you auction it?
Not the auction. I could sing some background music for the...
Yes, do.
So how many Cat Stevens fans out there? Only five. Never heard. Yusuf Islam. That's what changes me. You know this song?
Here I'll end up well, I think. Only God really knows.
Check this out.
I sat upon a setting sun, but never.
She don't know about that.
Never wanted more than
Get those tickets ready. Thank you for listening, everybody. I'm going off. I hope that you all have a marvelous journey this summer.
Hope you everybody had a wonderful time.
Oh, yeah.
Now we have a CD which is Glen Roethel. It's a small thing. So that's what we are going to travel. Everybody got the ticket?
Okay.
Okay, she's bringing you.
We'll have to put these in there.
Yes, over here.
Okay, and also we are going to do the raffle for the Friends of the Library also tonight.
You want a picture now?
It's in Kauai. Yeah, the Kauai in the north.
I'm sorry, I had to call and find out what time the program was. I went down to see a show and I was late. And I was, of course, meeting was starting at 7:30. I have to call back. No way. But I'm here and I'm so glad to see everybody is here and smiling. Wonderful music. I'm sorry, yes. I just have to call back. But I'm sure I'll hear it on one of these CDs. Okay.
And I have to personally thank you, Charlotte, so much for helping. Without Charlotte's help, nothing is possible.
Does everybody have a ticket?
Yeah. Yes.
Everybody has one of your yellow tickets?
Yes.
Okay.
No.
Genevieve needs a yellow ticket.
Who has it?
Who has some tickets?
The chair. Mm-hmm.
It's on the chair.
Okay, last call for tickets.
It's behind
you. Oh, I won. Oh, sorry. Oh, look, it says Charlotte. No. All right. I got to wait for Genevieve's ticket to come catch up with us. So, Swadish, what's our first prize? This is the prize.
wait a minute.
Sorry, we're so used to, this is how we clean our shelves. We got. Throw Okay, guys, everybody ready? Hold your breath. Here we go. I won't even look as if I would know whose number I'm picking. Okay, ready? Here we go.
Yes.
The first four numbers are 4559. Who's got those?
Oh, good.
Okay. And the next three numbers are 487.
No.
Oh, here we go. Yeah. What's your name?
The
same,
right?
Round of Morgan, everybody. Okay, what do we got now, Spudish? What's the next?
Okay, we'll think.
Okay, now everybody who's been in the library is familiar with the three baskets that are on the display case with the books. They've been there for a month or so. That's a raffle being held by our friends of our libraries to raise money for these programs. So I'm going to turn this over to Connie. She's a friend of the library.
A very good friend.
Okay. The first one is for the first basket.
Right. The author's basket.
The children's basket is first?
No, go for the biggest one first.
The author's basket is first.
No, it says on the ticket first prize.
Well, I would think that the first prize would be the...
Oh, my goodness.
Well, I'm not going to...
Ginger Crosby.
Oh, Ginger. Oh. Okay.
Come on, Ginger, come on
Ginger, stand. And Ginger is...
Ginger is also a friend of
friend the library. And
the library.
And always baking fresh cookies for us.
Yes.
For all of us.
Okay.
And this is for, what is this for now?
This is for the children's basket.
Okay.
Joanne Conley, C-O-N-L-O-Y. Joanne, her phone number is here.
Okay.
So she's not here, I guess.
Oh, Joanne Conway, yeah, she's just left.
You know who she is?
Yeah.
Okay, the last basket. Winnie Heinziger.
Okay. Well, it's nice to know we get our regulars here. Good. We hate people who come in one time and win everything. Good.
I just want to thank all of you. Know, after this program, we have refreshment here, and it's all the people. I want to thank all of them who brought the refreshment, and some baked it. Sandy Barham, Jim Doyle, and Penny Woods, and also Connie Mucci. So, thank you, everybody. And hope everybody had a good time.
If you have any questions about the summer reading program, you can ask me, or myself, or Swadish about it. Any questions, okay? Anybody who came in late and missed the general directions? Did you do the sign up is over there?
Yes.
Sorry,
Hello. Hello, lamppost. What you knowing? Come to watch your flowers growing. You got no rhyme for me. Do.
Feeling groovy.
Oh, yes.
Ba-da-da.
Ba-da-da. Ba-da-da.